Daytona's 10 most famous lights. Number 10.
Wallace, certainly a fun personality to have with us in the NASCAR.
Florida's weather.
He was seventh here a year ago, leader of the Sunoco Rookie of the Year standings, and boy, he has been fun to watch this season.
Well, fans, you can listen to the ninth NASCAR Xfinity Series broadcast of the Subway Firecracker 250 powered by Coca-Cola with Joe Moore and Jeff Striegel in the booth. Dave Moody, Mike Bagley, and Kurt Becker in the turns. And Winston Kelly, Alex Hayden, and Steve Post on pit road. And our social media reporter, Kim Kuhn. All the exciting action on MRN's call of tonight's race can be heard on FM 93.5 and 1150 WAM 1150 WNBB. Don't have a radio? Well, try your local station's website or log on to MRN.com to listen live. You can also get the new free MRN app at the App Store and on Google Play for Android. MRN coverage is also available right now on your scanner at 454.000.
Race fans, it's almost time to meet the starting lineup for tonight's Subway Firecracker 250 powered by Coca-Cola. Please remember, once the driver introductions conclude, we ask that you please return to your seats in preparation for the start of tonight's Subway Firecracker 250. Again, immediately following the driver introductions, please clear the ball field and pre-race area and return to your seats. Thank you.
The inside line comes to life. Five cars break away for the sixth position. That's where you find Joey Logano.
Sellers, then it's Mike Harmon, Dexter Bean, Eric McClure, all of those cars on the lead lap, 39 of them in all. One lap down, running 40th is Bobby Gearhart.
Pace car is on pit road, the green flag waving again here at Daytona. They are on the gas. Again, Brian Scott drives the breakaway. Gonna get the Anthony on the sideline. There's still room. He's got the lead now by a car length. And Ryan Scott rallies up the inside for second.
Bold move off of turn number two by Daniel Suarez. That's going to give him the lead right behind him, Brian Scott. Right behind him, Ty Dillon.
Field.
Out of the top 10, possibly out of the top dozen. In fact, he will fall back into the 13th position, almost in contact.
Dillon got out of that race car turn, and I think you can hear the crowd in the background acknowledging Austin Kleinig from that just destroyed race car.
It was a really good look, and one thing that was so cool is everybody was past the start-finish line. The wreck happened after that, and when I was sitting there, the crew ran out. A lot of crew guys to help Austin Dillon. It was safe for them to do that, and Austin had a lot of those crew guys trying to help him. We got a catch fence tour up a little bit. We have to take a look at this later on.
All right, Rusty, thank you very much. Now, this was a wild end to this. Let's not forget that Dale Earnhardt Jr., he won today as we see the engine actually laying in the infield grass of Austin Dillon's car. Boy, that's going to make a top 10 list somewhere. But the good news is, again, Austin Dillon did climb from that race car. Same for Brad Keselowski. Other cars were involved. We believe at this particular point that everybody is okay. Our congratulations to Dale Earnhardt Jr. He has won here at Daytona for the fourth time in his career. He was out front at the end of the AutoZone Go Zone. Every NASCAR driver knows the closing laps of a race are when the tensions mount and victory is within sight. With the laps counting down, it's time to make your move and get to the front. You're in the AutoZone Go Zone.
Just an incredible finish here at Daytona, and just so, so very happy to see that Austin Dillon able to get out of the car in just a matter of seconds. The crew was
just very frightening. Really glad that everybody's okay. Hate to see the race end that way.
Looked like it was going to be between you and Jimmy Johnson most of the day, the two strongest cars. What do you feel like gave you the edge to come home to victory lane?
Just the power in this car and the ability this car has to pass. We got shuffled back a few times. And it's all race car when you're trying to make the moves to get back up there. If you know where to put it, it'll go and get to where you want to go. So I made some good choices, but the car's got to be able to make that happen. And if it can't, you're not going to go anywhere. So a lot of good race car power, engine Hendrick power, and then these guys standing here that put it together. It's just amazing. Such a treat. I just feel real lucky that I've been in such good equipment at Daytona and Talladega pretty much my whole career. It's been an amazing ride.
Second time in 2015, he's in victory lane, backing up Talladega. Fourth time at Daytona, Dale Earnhardt Jr. in victory lane.
All right, Winston, thank you, and of course, I congratulate you.